Hey there, do-it-yourself technicians. This is a dual-purpose episode. Firstly, to let you know that you are amazing and able to do things and fix things that you have no idea of when you start. You just have to try. Secondly, if you happen to have a Fanatec Clubsport Elite Racing Steering Wheel with a broken pin, this video will show you how I fixed one. You really are capable of so much. I just wanted to tell you that. When I started this repair, I had no idea whether I was going to be able to do it or not. We are all capable of so much more than we know. I started out with a steering wheel with a broken connector pin and a set of instructions for a couple of different, slightly different steering wheels. They gave me the idea that it could be done and a path to start on. I had the brains in my head and the recognition that what I wanted to do was probably possible. That was enough for me. At the same time, I wasn't going to make it any worse. It was already broken. In the end, I got it back to basically as good as new. And new, in this case, costs $600 to $1,000. And at the time, there was a wait of between 1 and 3 months for delivery. So it was worth a shot. This is a much longer episode than usual. I've sped up a couple of bits, but basically left it as it was recorded on the day. I've also taken out a couple of bits where I went searching for tools or stopped for food. Only in certain sections will I actually narrate what I was doing at the time. The first step was to remove the screws on the front of the wheel. Now I flip it over to remove the connective mechanism from the wheel itself. There was a few more screws on the bottom. Then I was able to unplug the circuit board connector. The next step was to free the collar. Now I could slide the head out, followed by the cable and its connector. Then came the center screw. Here I shuffled around and counted the cables and pins to make sure that there were spare pins. There was a bit of force required to remove the outer collar, as it was also glued on. I was finally down to the required part, but it was very firmly glued together. There was nothing else that I could do but apply some heat. And more heat. And burn my fingers with more heat. and try and shape and remove the glue with pliers and a knife. Until I was able to push one of the spare pins out and remove it. Now I had to remove the broken pin and cable. This required more heating and shaping. At the same time, trying to keep the rest of the pins aligned so as not to cause issues putting it back together again. Here I desoldered the green wire from the broken pin. But I still had to get the pin out, which involved clearing all of the solder and glue from the pin because it was a tight squeeze. Yay! I finally got it out! Now to put the new pin in. Here I'm realigning all of the pins to the collar. Now I have to strip back the insulation from the wire. Now I have to tin it and solder it to the new pin. Thank you. Now I go through and inspect everything carefully to make sure I haven't damaged anything. Here I'm realigning all of the pins and making sure they're all the same length so that they all connect properly when connected back in. Now I'm applying some glue to hold it all in place. And then it's time to put everything back together. Thank you. The interesting thing is that there's nothing really difficult about what I did. I used all pretty basic tools. In fact, the heat gun was stolen from my wife's crafting supplies. It took some faith in myself, some time, and some persistence. The whole job took close to 2 hours, but it was worth it for me, and it was worth it for Pete. He was more than happy to pay to get back to his retirement hobby. Question of the day. Do you reckon you could tackle a project like that? Let me know in the comments down below. And if this was useful to you, give it a thumbs up. Thank you so much. The Tech Doctor exists to help you become your own technician. Learn about the technology, protect yourself from the bad guys, and fix it when it breaks. If you're watching this on YouTube, there's some older videos you may not have seen before, here and here. And you can click the logo down here to subscribe, or the one up here to join our mailing list. Thank you so much for watching. Have a great day, and I'll see you on the next episode.